Hello students, today again here we go to study about the super senses. Okay, we have already studied in the last two lectures lots of things, so let's see what we have to learn something new in this lecture. So we will study about the some kinds of problems which is given in your book and it is based on the previous lecture. Then we have to study about the position of the different birds, animals and its benefit. We will study the book exercise based on the position of eyes. Then vision of the different colors in various animals. We will study the advantage of the shape and the size of the ears also. And then touch, sound, scent, masses. So we have to study. We will start first with the book exercise. So let's see what is the first book exercise it given in your book. In what ways the human beings make use of the special sense of smell of dog? As you recall my previous lecture, I have told you that dogs has the very good sense of smell. So in this question it is asking that how we can use this super sense of dog in our daily life. So if you have seen the movies also, you can see that you have seen that in that investigation department always takes the help of dog for this super senses to find the bomb or any kinds of the harmful objects or material, as well as we can use the smell of sense dogs to find the stolen things. If we want to find the stolen things, we can take the help of dogs. Then next one is, when do you find your sense smell helpful to you? List some examples like by its smell that food has gone bad or something is burning. Students, as you know that we also have the sense of smell. So how this sense of smell is helpful in our daily life? So you can write it a point wise. This sense of smell is helpful to smell perfumes, to smell flowers, to smell delicious food. When your mama is cooking something in kitchen and it smells very delicious, you feel always hungry. Okay, so this sense of smell also used to smell the delicious food also. And you can write that smell of the bad things or stolen food also, you can write of bad things which you don't like. Alright, so the next thing is that the next question, name the animals that you would be able to recognize by their smell without seeing them. Students, there are different types of animals to whom we can recognize just by their smell. In the first one, and that is dog. You can recognize dog with its smell without looking at it. Fish also can be recognized with its smell only. Tell me about the cow. Can you recognize it by its smell? Yes, of course we can recognize it just by its smell. So the next one is, write the name of 5 things whose smell you like and 5 things whose smell you don't like. Here you have to write the 5 things whose smell you like and the name of the 5 things which you don't like. Student, you can write here the smell you like of perfume, smell you like of the delicious food. You can write the smell of jalebi also if you like it. You can write the smell of rasgulla also if you like it. You can write the smell of the flower also if you like it. It depends, completely depends on you that what kind of smell you like. And here you have to write the smell of the different things that you don't like. So you can write here the smell of the garbage if you don't like, smell of the stale food if you don't like, smell of the burnt food if you don't like. So different things you can write. Next, let's see. Did you ever come across any smell in crowded place such as fair, bus or trains? Students, often you move from one place to another place and you feel some different kinds of smell just because of some kinds of garbage or just because of the sweat of the different crowded people. So you have to write here, yes. Next, Today, Rajni had to go out for some important work. She had to leave her 6-month-old son Deepak with her sister Sushila. Sushila also has a baby of the same age. It was funny that both the babies did potty at the same time. She happily cleaned up her daughters, but when she was cleaning her sister's son Deepak, she covered her nose with her dupatta. Okay, so what is it is asking? So Sheila covered her nose when she cleaned up Deepak's nappy, but did not when she cleaned her daughter. Why do you think that? Why she did this? Students, she did this because she always thinks that her child's nappy is not dirty, and she thought that her sister's child nappy is dirty. It completely depends on our feeling that the whose smell we like and whose smell we don't like. If we feel that something is dirty, its smell we don't like, and if we feel that something is not dirty, its smell we like. So here Sushila feel that her child's nappy is not dirty, that's why she doesn't cover her nose. The next one is, how did you feel when you walk near the heap garbage? You feel dirty, and that's why you feel it bad smell. Okay, but think the children who spend the whole day picking things from such garbage. Student, as I have told you already, that when we feel that something is dirty, we feel it bad smell. But the person who is working near these kinds of garbage, they never think that this is dirty. That's why they never feel it bad, and they never feel the bad smell also. Is a smell good or bad for everyone in the same way? No, not at all, because the smell good or bad, it depends on the feeling of the person. If they think that it is dirty, they feel it bad smell, and if they think that it is not dirty, they feel it not bad. Okay, or does it depends on how they feels about it? Yes, of course it depends on the how it they feel about it. So the next, we have to discuss about the position of the eyes in some birds and animals. Students, have you ever seen the position of your eyes? Of course, it is always in front of your face. But what about the parrot, pigeon, crow, hen? Their eyes always placed at the sides of their face. So what is the advantage of these kinds of the position of eyes? So first, some animals and birds have the eyes at the front of their face. What is the benefit of it? It helps them to look straight at the certain distance. Okay, these kinds of animals cannot see their sides without moving their neck. Student, can you see your sides without moving your neck? If you are looking straight and somebody is coming from your sides, can you able to see? No, of course not. If you are moving your neck, then only you will be able to see. If you are not moving your neck, you are not able to see. But most of the birds have their eyes on their sides of the heads. As I have given you example, that is parrot, crow, pigeon, peacock, hen, and another different kinds of the birds which have the eyes on its sides of the head. Their eyes can focus on the two different things at the same time. They can see their both sides at the same time. When they look straight ahead, both their eyes focus on the same object. When they always used to look at the straight, they can focus on the object at the same time also. Okay, examples also given here. Now the next one is, again, the book exercise based on the position of eyes. Write the name of the bird which has eyes in front of its head. Which bird? That is owl. Write the name of the some birds which have eyes on either side of the head. What is the size of their eyes as compared to the size of their head? Okay, here you have to write the name of the bird. You can write hen, peacock, parrot, etc. And again it is asking that what is the size of their eyes. It always is small in comparison to their head. Now, size of the ear and its benefit. Some animals have big ears. One of the important functions of big ears in animals is to act it as a cooling system. Students, Basically, the animals which are present into the very hot climate, they always have the big ears, because this big ears is responsible to remove the heat from their body. So they become cool and they feel cool by releasing the heat through their ears, and it also provide the better hearing. Okay, for example, bat or elephant. Better hearing you can explain by the simple kinds of activities here. You can place your both hand just at the back of your ear and try to listen any kind of sound. You will be clear it very clearly. You will be able to listen it very clearly as compared than when you have not placed your eyes behind your ear. Okay, the next one is some animals have small ears. These kinds of animals mostly found in cold areas. As I have told you that the bigger areas, in the hotter areas, the big ear animal found, because they release the heat through their ear. But in the cold areas, there is more heat energy is required to store in their body. That's why their ear are very small. Okay, small ear reduce the loss of heat of their body through it. So the animal which have the bigger ear, you can see in the diagram, that is elephant, and with the small ear, that is polar bear. Now, the next topic, that is sound sends messages. Students, have you ever thought that the sound can also send the messages? Just tell me, when there is no teacher in your class and you are all howling, starting shouting at the same time, when your teachers come, you without saying anything, you just send a message by producing a different kinds of sound like hey ho, oh yeah. So these kinds of sounds are responsible for sending the message. So let's see what is saying in this topic. Some animals produce special sound to send messages to their friends. You can also produce the special sound to send them your messages. Okay, the first we have to talk about the langur. Langur warns other dangers like tiger or leopard. The langur does this by making a special warning call. Okay, bird also give the alarm call to warn about the danger. Many birds even have the different sounds for different kinds of danger. For example, if there is something different warning call, and if their enemy is coming, there will be the different types of the sounds also. Fishes gives the alarm call by producing the electric signals, and we can also send the message to out of friends by making the different kinds of sounds, as I have discussed it already. Next, dolphin also make the different sounds to give messages to each other. Okay, scientists believe that many animals have a special language of their own. Students, so this is all about the students. This is all about the different topics. Now let's see what is the book exercise is given here. Can you understand the sound of some animals? Which animals? Okay. Can you understand the sounds of animals? You can understand the sounds of cow. If cow is shouting, there is a sound of cow, you can easily recognize that it is the cow. You can also understand sounds of dog, hen, parrot. So there are the large varieties of animal to whom you can understand just by their sounds. Does some animals understand your language? Which one? Students, have you ever seen dog? It can understand your language. If it is at your home, when you have ordered it, just stand up, don't go, they can easily understand your language. So dog can easily understand your language, parrot can easily understand your language, cat can also easily understand your language. So you can write the different types of the name of the animals who can understand your language. Students, all right, this is all about today's lecture. So, thank you.